So we have both our handles on and make sure that they're not twisted. So you see this here, yeah, it goes and lays flat. Same thing on the other side. Now, choose one of the side seams. And this is a very important step again. You have your fold lines here that you pressed over before. So on the bottom, you will see that one line is going this way. So you keep it this way as well. However, up here, you turn it in the other direction. You have your stitch line here, which is also a fold line. And then you have the other fold line, which you press down. So now what this does, you have the French seam sitting here, and you have it sitting here, which eliminates the bulk, and in here it twists. What I want you to do is put the side seams right on top of one another and start stitching in here until one stitch from the edge, and then you start edge stitching. Now, this is going to be a little bit tricky. I want you to make sure that this is all laying flat and all the loose threads are out of the way. So, what I want you to do is edge stitch to your first handle. And make sure this is all laying flat, you're not pulling too much. And there, when you're there, I want you to stop. Because now, we're going to add our pockets. The inside pockets. Now you need to decide, do you want to... No, I'm having the front here, because you can see the stitch line. So if you want the zipper pocket closer to your body, you would use the pocket with the button and the buttonhole. You look that this is fitting right between your two handles. If it is a little bit wider, good for you. Means your seams were tighter. If it isn't and it goes underneath, just distribute it that it will sit evenly on the sides. Then what I want you to do is to take the pocket and move it about a centimeter in here so that your seam allowance is going to be here. Leave the handle where it is, and you see this? You continue stitching. Do the same thing on this side. Move it in a centimeter. Make sure that your handle lays flat. And then stitch this down with an edge stitch. And as you can see here, now you know why we are so precise with everything. There you go. So you do that, then you get to the next side seam, and again we look which orientation it has on the bottom. This is facing us, so keep that in mind. So, now, we're getting to the point where we have our side seam. Remember, for mine, it faces us. Here, done it already automatically. I move this to the other side, fold it down, and fold this over so that we have one seam allowance here and one seam allowance there. Make sure that this line matches up and you stitch it down. So now we're getting over to the next handle. Again, we move all of our frets out of the way. We make sure this is laying flat. Looks nice and neat. And we're stitching towards our handle. And with a few stitches in, and we stop there. Now we put the other pocket, depending on which one it is, and again measure, see if it fits in between or if it overlaps. I know this one fits. So, and then again we put it 1 centimeter underneath the edge here. And edge stitch this on. And as you can see, matches. So from there, again, we go towards our side seam. Just get rid of all the frets in there. And take your time. I've done a few thousand of those, so we're not in a competition. So when we're getting there, what I want you to do is, instead of going up here, just go over that edge, back tack, and then cut your frets. When we're done that, we turn the bag and we're going into the same seam, starting again in here. And what that does, it hides the beginning. So, and then I need you to edge stitch again. And this is a bit more tricky. So go as slow as you want to. But when we get to the handle, what I want you to do is fold this over. Not that the handle pulls like this, but the break line is actually a little bit underneath the stitch line. What I want you to do then is to go over the handle, one stitch from the edge, lift your foot, see where your handle sits here, so aim in a straight line diagonally. So you turn that, you have the handle now perpendicular, you go up to that edge, into the seam line. If you want it a little bit closer, there you go. Make sure that your pocket is going all the way down. The only thing that sticks out here is your handle. So now from there we go to here, There we go. Turn it again. And make sure when you turn that your needle is in. This machine does it automatically, so I don't have to watch it. And then you go, make sure pocket is on the side there. Edge stitch to your next handle. Again, make sure that the handle lays flat. And as you can see here, see it doesn't pull like this. It lays nicely. Again, go over it. Go across. One more. And you're working these corners so that you would actually, if you stay in here and you go on, you would be doing an edge stitch right here. So what this little thing does is it increases the weight capacity from about 5 kilos where the handles or the seams would split in that area to over 20 kilos if not more, just by doing those stitches. So I just went over the side seam and now I'm getting to the point where I have my other handle. So again, I make sure that the handle lays flat, seam is not pulling. I go across, again one stitch away from the edge here. Make sure I'm going to this corner, so one stitch in is here. I'm going straight for that. Turn it around. Going up there, turning it again, needle is in. We know our handle goes down to here, so about a millimeter over, and we go into the stitch line and then up, and then we turn it here. Again, making sure the pocket lays in there. So, and another one. Go over here. Turn it. Go to this corner. And then we're getting to the other side seam, and as you can see, my thread is still hanging here. So what I do on this side is actually I'm going into the side seam again, stitching down here, doing my back tacking in here, and cut my threads off. This way you get a really clean line here. Your thread might be hanging there. You just snip that. And this is how your little squares will look like. Here's the pocket on the inside. And guess what? Your bag is finished. Bye.